Wow, look at this belt, John. It's totally shredded.
And you know what's interesting? We just had a power steering pump put on not too long ago.
And you know, John, if you don't put this power steering pump pulley on correct, this is gonna happen every time.
And you know, to be safe, Chase, let's just go ahead. I got you a brand new pulley, and we need to show them how to put a pulley on and take one off as well. So go ahead and put this on. While you do that, I'll actually show you a little bit about accessory belt drive systems. Now, we have to understand about the belt because the power steering pump is an accessory that the belt drives. So this is very, very common. And here's what happens. You can actually see it right here. If it's not tracking right, it's gonna actually start shredding around the edges. That's why it's so important to put the pulley on in the correct position. Eventually, it actually snapped right here and broke. Now, the accessory belt drive system is a system, so we have to look at the entire thing, but let's go back to belts. Remember, we used to take a belt. Now, this belt drives everything, and it's actually a neoprene belt. This is a little bit older, and if I squeeze it right here, you can see all these cracks right here. Well, we used to count the cracks in there, and then we could determine if the belt's good or bad. Can't do that anymore. Today's belts are EPDM material, a little bit different. Think of an analogy of a tire. It wears like a tire. When a tire wears, the treads start to go down. It's going to ride on that pulley. And once it starts to wear out, it's actually starting to slip on that pulley. It actually introduces heat into the power steering pump, and it could do damage. So it's very important to check the belt. Well, how do you check them? Well, it's pretty cool. You can get this tool right here. You can get one of these, and I got three belts here. I actually have an old worn belt, I have an age belt, and I have a brand new belt. And what I want to do is I want to start right here on the old belt. So if I go down on the old belt, what's happening is this tool's going down in these ribs. Now, when it goes down in the ribs, it's wearing out. Those ribs, like a tire, are getting deeper and deeper and deeper. We're introducing heat into the pulley. If I go over to the aged one and I put it in there, well, it's sticking out a little bit, but on the new one, it sticks out quite a bit here at the top. Now, I could bend these belts after 100,000 miles and you really wouldn't even see any cracks. So it's important that you use these tools. It's important that you have a belt that rides right, that's not introducing heat, and it's tracking correctly. Now, a couple other things. We can look at our accessory belt drive system right here on the board. It's driven by the harmonic balancer right here. The crankshaft drives that. It goes around to a tensioner, and then it's coming up to our power steering pulley. So you can see the power steering pulley right here, and it also drives other accessories. So think about, once this thing breaks or gives out, it's catastrophic failure. Not only are you not gonna have power steering, you're not gonna have alternator charging. If it drives a water pump, it could be catastrophic damage because you're not cooling the engine as well. Now, how's this work? Well, it goes around and there's a tensioner, another key part right here. This is the tensioner. It's an automatic tensioner. It holds tension on the belt through the whole duty cycle. Every time the air condition comes on, it wants to jolt a little bit, this guy has to hold tension on it. Now, too much tension, once again, you're going to do damage to the bearings. You're pulling down on that belt, you're hurting it. Not enough tension, it's going to slip, introducing heat into the pulley. So here's a quick test that you can do. So it's pretty cool. Run the car, be very, very safe. Get away from the belt. Take your spray bottle. Spray a little water on the largest span right there. Water acts as a lubricant, so if the belt starts squealing, you probably need some tension. If the squeal goes away temporarily, you may have an alignment issue, and that's as critical as well. And you can see I have a tension tool right here also. I can put that on the longest span. We'll do it once we get our truck set up, and we'll actually check it and make sure we got the right tension on the belt. Now, alignment, another issue. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this belt off so I can show you a cool tool called a laser alignment. Just because you put that power steering pump on with that tool, it's not guaranteed that you actually have the pulley in the right spot. It could be off or on a little bit, causing some tracking problems. That's what's happening to our truck. So what I have here is I have this laser aligner, and this laser aligner is real cool. You can see it right here, and if I turn it on, it actually makes a little beam right here. So what you do is you actually take this laser aligner and you put it in the grooves of the pulley. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shoot down to the other pulley. And when I do that, I put it in the fourth or fifth rib of the actual groove here, and it's shooting to the fourth or fifth rib, I'm in good shape. But I actually have this one loose. So if I move it to the left or to the right, you can see I'm gonna have a tracking issue. Now, this is just a demo, obviously. This isn't even held by a bearing, but that's what's going on with the power steering pump. Our belt's getting shredded. You're gonna have some issues. Chase, looks like you're coming along pretty good there.
Yeah, I got the old pulley off. I wanna show you exactly what I did. If you'll just hold that pulley right there. Now, here's our power steering pump puller. Now, what I'm gonna do, this is the puller here. It's gonna sit inside and butt up to the shaft, okay? Mm-hmm. Then I got two collars here. One collar's gonna go on here, like so. Hold that for me there. Mm-hmm. Got one on the bottom. Then I'm gonna slightly just tighten this up a little bit, get a little pressure against it.
Okay.
Then I'll put this collar over the top. Now, it'll hold it and make sure if it comes apart, it won't blow apart. All right, now, all I wanna do is take a wrench and I'm gonna put it on this bolt here and hold. I want to hold it. and then I put another wrench on here, then I start turning it. Now as I turn it, it's gonna start pulling that pulley right off the shaft, and then you can go ahead and put your new one on and get lined up.
Well, we have one on a bench to show you. We'll show you the installation tool and how to put it back together. Now, how important it is to put the pulley on and take it off with the proper tools, we're gonna show it to you right here on the bench once again, so you got it down pat. But before we do that, I know the temptation is to get a pry bar, pull behind there, start to wiggle it and get it off. Don't wanna do that. Got a hammer, you can knock it from the back, try to get it off, still gonna do damage, not the idea. I've even seen people take pullers, go in there in the holes and the fingers, try to use it on the shaft and actually pull it off, do massive damage to the pulley and actually the shaft going into the power steering pump. Can't do any of those. So just resist the temptation and I'll show you how to do it one more time. Now I got this one 90% off, so it's gonna take a lot of muscle at first, but what I wanna show you is once again, the removal tool. And the removal tool was real simple. I get a little better angle here so you can see it, but I'm gonna put it on, just like Chase did over on the vehicle, from the top and the bottom. Now, one thing I wanna show you is these holes right here are the actual groove. If your pulley doesn't have a groove, you can't use this. And be careful, it may be a plastic pulley as well. But if you have this groove right here, that's where the tool is actually gonna sit, right in that groove. So I'm gonna put it in there. I'm gonna put it together, lock it together, hold it, take the safety collar once again and put it on there, and then I snug it up just to hold it. I said I have it 90% of the way off, so hopefully this thing will pull and come right off without too much effort, but you're gonna have to really pull on this thing to break it loose. Matter of fact, we had to put a big breaker bar on to get it to pop to start to come. Once it started to come off, we were in good shape. So I'm gonna hold this one, and when I hold this one, I'm just gonna turn this one around, and when I turn this one around, it's actually pulling. What's happening? The puller's moving up this shaft, and when it moves up the actual puller shaft, it's connected to the pulley, it's pulling it off the power steering shaft. The key is, it's pulling it off straight, it's pulling it off symmetrical, and it's not putting any undue damage on the shaft going into the power steering pump, not doing any damage to the pump at all. So this is the proper way to do it. So you just keep turning this around, and as you turn it around, it's gonna get looser and looser. There it goes. But remember, I had it 90% of the way off. So you wanna make sure that you use that brute force at the beginning to get it moving. Now, to install it, just reverse the procedure, but you need another tool. The installation, you're gonna get it started on there. Now, once again, while you got it off, go ahead, check your bearings, check everything, make sure you don't have any leakage, check your shaft, the end play here, make sure everything's in good shape, look for any burrs, make sure your pulley's in good shape. You wanna look at all the teeth inside of here, everything. Then I'm gonna go ahead and install it. So I'm just gonna get it started here by hand, make sure that it's straight. Then I'm gonna take the installer. Now, the installer, like Chase is gonna show you here in a minute, you're gonna put it in the shaft of the actual power steering pump, it threads in. You wanna get a few threads in there and get it pretty good, or when you go to pull it, you're gonna rip the threads right out of the pump. You don't wanna do that as well. So I'm gonna back it off and get it in there till it's seated in there pretty good. Once it's pretty good, now I got it set up. Now I'm double checking everything. I'm making sure it's straight. I'm making sure that this is all lined up. I'm making sure it's not crooked. I don't wanna force it on there. It should go on pretty easily at this point. So what I'm gonna do now is put the wrench and just kind of reverse the procedure. I'm gonna hold this one, and this time I'm gonna turn it inward. So as I'm turning it inward, what's going on is I'm actually taking this and I'm pushing it on. Once again, straight, not crooked. Once again, not doing any undue damage to the shaft. I'm not pulling on the bearings. The pump's gonna be in good shape. So all I have to do is just come over here now and tighten it up and tighten it up and tighten it up. And eventually it's gonna push it all the way on and you're gonna feel it bottom out. Well, it bottomed out. That's a good place to stop. Once I stop, I can pull it off. That doesn't mean it's perfectly aligned. We're still gonna have to go with that laser aligner and look at the tracking of the belt. So with this, I think Chase has got ours underway. Let's check in with him.
John, I've got the pulley completely installed. It bottomed out. Now we just need to check it with the laser aligner.
Yeah, no matter what. Once it bottoms out, you know you're at a starting point. But we went ahead and we took our laser aligner, we put it on the alternator and a couple other pulleys, we shot it down to the power steering pump, and it was dead on. So you know what? That was perfect. Also, we took our brush, we went around to all the pulleys, we cleaned them off really, really well, made sure they're in good shape. Another tip for you, if you don't have it, make sure you get the belt routing diagram. This is huge. Or take a picture of it, or make sure it's on the vehicle, because sometimes there's a lot of pulleys and a lot of routing that could get a little bit crazy. Make sure you have this belt routing diagram. Chase, it's a matter of putting the belt on now.
Yeah, if you'll just pull that tensioner down, I'll go ahead and slip this belt on the alternator.
Awesome, and I'm just gonna pull down on this. Now we have our air box off, make it a little bit easier, and so you can see, we get the belt put on the alternator right here.
There
Once we get that on, release the tension.
That thing looks good.
Yep, make sure that you go around, check everything, make sure it's on all the pulleys. Like I said, we have our air box off, our mass airflow. Let's see if it'll run for a second, just to see if it's tracking. It's always a good idea.
Sounds good.
We may have to put that air box on, but let's give it a shot. Go ahead and crank it up. We want to watch for it tracking. Go ahead. Great. Now, what I'm looking for, I'm actually watching the belt, and it's riding on the pulleys. I don't want to see it go to the left or to the right of one of the pulleys. Now, what you also want to do is take it on a test drive. Another good point. Bring it back in. Pop the hood. Take a few minutes. Look around. If you see it starting to fray on the inside or outside, we have the same problem. Just make sure that power steering pump's put on with the right tools. And if you do that, the power steering pump's going to last a long time.